Hello friends, welcome to the video tutorial of Chef and Trump Cards. So here Chef is playing a card game with Chefu. So there are two piles of cards. At any moment, each card in the game has a positive integer value. That means there are no zero and negative numbers. So the game is played in rounds. In each round, each player simultaneously draws one card from the top of his pile. So if a player's pile is empty, then he cannot draw a card and therefore loses the game. And if the value of the drawn cards are equal, they are simply placed under the bottom of their piles. Otherwise, the player whose card has a higher value wins the round and he gets to place his card at the bottom of his pile. And he also gets the card of the other player, but the other player's card value is decremented by 1. So if it becomes 0 or negative, it is removed from the game. And if no transfer of cards happen during 10 raised to power 100 consecutive rounds, then each player calculates the sum of the values of the card that are currently in his pile, and if one player has a higher sum, then this player wins the game, otherwise the game ends in a draw. So what is our task? Our task is we are given n cards and the value of the n cards. Our task is to distribute the cards between the players before the start of the game so that the game never ends in a draw, and we need to count the number of ways we can do that. Since it is a very large number, we will compute it modulo 10 raised to power 9 plus 7. So we are given an input test, number of test cases, then the number of input integers, and then the integers which represent the value of the cards. So as you can see that n is 10 raised to power 5. Hence our solutions time complexity should be O n log n or O m, as the sum of n does not exceed 10 raised to power 6. O n is preferable, but O n log n also works. So let us move on to the explanation part. So the solution to this problem is very easy. Let us suppose we have the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and another 5. So let us take an example in which we distribute the numbers as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 5. So in the first round, 4 is greater than 1, so 1 is transferred to him, but as 1 is decremented by 1, so the value becomes 0 and it is removed. So the game becomes 2, 3, 5, 4, sorry, 5 and 4, because 4 becomes below 5. So now what we do, just a second. So now what we do, 2, 3, 5, 5 is greater than 2. So 2 is transferred, this becomes 3. So we continue playing the game. Now 5 is equal to 5, so 5, 1, 4, 2, 5. Now 5 is removed, 1 is removed, sorry. So 5, 4, 2, 5. As you will see that as we go on, in the end only 5 and 5 will be left, and this game ends in a draw. So what do we infer from this example? Okay, so there were, the maximum value was 5 and 5. Okay, one, I will tell you a trick. Suppose this game has to end in a draw. That means there should be no card transfers for 10 raised to power 100. There should be no card transfers for 10 raised to power 100 moves. That means suppose the numbers are A1, then it should be equal to B1. A2 should be equal to B2. Dot 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 till an should be equal to bn, or the other case can be that all the numbers are equal, so a1 equal to a2, equal to an, and this is equal to b1 dot 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 till bm, then also this holds. But now, as the sum also should be equal, so this case is invalid, because sum of bn's is equal to sigma an only when ai equal to 0, which is not true. Hence, the only case we are left with is a1 equals b1, a2 equals b2, an equals bn. Now, some of them can be equal. So, this is the first property. So, now the next property that we see is, let us suppose this sequence has a maximum number, as it is a sequence of only positive integers and finite sequence of positive integers, it will always have a maximum value. So in this case, the maximum value is 5. So count the number of times the maximum value occurs. Either it will occur an even number of times, mod 2 is equal to 0, or it will occur an odd number of times, that is mod 2 is equal to 1. So now, when Chef and Chefu play the game, there, whenever the maximum value card comes on the top, the other player will have either a maximum value card or a non-maximum value card. If he has a non-maximum value card, the cards just go down. If he has a non-maximum value card, then it is transferred to the other player. So what do we infer from that? That we cannot reduce the value of the maximum value card after any number of transfers during the game, because there is no card which has a value higher than the maximum value card. And whenever any other card comes in the way of the maximum value card, its value reduces. Hence, in the end, the chef and chefu will be left with only the maximum value cards. So in this case, the answer would be 5-5 if we distributed one maximum value card to each. If we had distributed both the maximum value cards to one player, then it had been 5-5 and empty stack. So let us take the first case, that max val count is even. So in this case, the game can only end in a draw if both the players are distributed. Let us just denote this by M. If both are distributed M by 2 max values, and the other cards can take 2 raised to power N possibilities. 2 raised to power n minus m possibilities, because it doesn't matter where does the non-maximum value card goes. In the end, it has to decrease to 0 and will be removed. And suppose it is odd, then however you distribute the max value count, one player will always have the max value count greater than the other one's max value count, and hence the sum will never be equal, and hence you can distribute them in 2 raised to power n ways. And so in this case, you can distribute the 2 raised to m by 2. So these are the cases when it will be a draw. So it will be 2 raised to power m minus this. Just a second. So our answer here will be 2 raised to power n minus m into the total number of ways we can distribute, so that it never ends in a draw, is 2 raised to power n minus mc m by 2. So now let us look at the code. So here is my code. So we declare a mod value, which is 10 raised to power 9 plus 7. And then to compute the MCJs or MC m by 2 in O1 time, we pre-compute the factorial to 10 raised to 5 and inverse factorial to 10 raised to 5. There is a power function which calculates a raised to b in log n time. Then there is an initialize function which fills the value of the factorials and the inverse factorials. There is an ncj function which calculates ncj by n factorial by n minus j factorial and mod it. Okay, so now we take the number of test cases, then we take the number of cards, then we input the values on these cards. Now we find the maximum value and the max count, the number of times the max count appears, the number of times the maximum value appears. Now we initialize a variable left that tells us the number of cards with non-max values. So the answer is 2 raised to power of 2 comma left. This is because the cards can appear in any of the types. Now if the max count is even, then we have to take care, because the only case when it will be draw, then the only case it will be draw would be when the max values are distributed equally between the two people. So the total number of cases 2 raised to max count minus the cases when they are distributed equally. Now if it is negative, we just increase it to become positive and we take a mod. Now answer will be the total number of ways to distribute the non-max values into the total number of ways to distribute the max values and then take a mod. Otherwise, if max count is odd, that means that we can take them max values and non-max values in any order as we want. So answer will be the number of ways to distribute non-max values into the number of ways to distribute max values, which can be in any order, so 2 raised to max count. Then we take a mod and then we print it. As you can see, it passes all the test cases successfully. Thank you for watching our video. Do like, subscribe and share, and come back for more courses and more videos. Thank you everyone.